in the base model that I use. There we go. In the model that I use to understand myself, my right side is my analytical side that can figure anything out and has flawless logic to itself. It can't perceive its own faults. It can observe them when they're pointed out, but you know, it always feels like it's right about everything. And when I have the leftward bellows locked, I'm in a frame of mind where whatever I thought, I can explain why I made it up. I can explain why everything's made up. But I can also feel when something's beneficial. And that's how I guide myself subconsciously. I just enjoy and appreciate, like, that's my role in this whole soup of somatic space that I can create through consciousness in my mind. The different sensory systems I can bring online at the same time in tandem to fully embody myself, to keep my muscle memory in a state of tension that keeps it awake, and the conduits. Fuel and breath to allow equal audience in this space where I can intuit and logic in a flow where, in the end, I don't know anything for anyone else, but I know a lot more for myself, and how I am influences how I influence the world. And when optimized and beneficial, people change themselves through an example. You know, like that's the best way to influence. You know, even like if someone's having a specific issue that you've experienced and know how to deal with, if you just tell the story of your fault about how you know exactly what they're going through, but not by connecting it, but just by explaining it the way you felt, the reason you feel like you understand. That way they can see the part of it that you do relate to. You know, there might be a much bigger breadth to it, but they're like, oh, they do get that. And that can infect them with the solution to your problem, which if it didn't go through another way, you can create the solutions for all the other problems instead of being like, oh, that wasn't the right solution. And be like, oh, it was the right solution. Oh, and this is why that's bullshit, you know. I perceive this left-right thing as me. both identities cohesively, because they're all different aspects of me. Like, this guy has access to memory. I'm trying to, like, build the routing over here. But I don't know if it's possible or if I want it. Like, it's like I just get the subconscious feeling of what the memory was, and only the part of it that I wanted. It keeps things clean over here. Keep your mind clean, you know, tend that garden. And, you know, if you're a lazy weed and you turn into a gardener and have to learn how to tend, you can start to realize your own mistakes, you know, where you went wrong along the way. And that's a weird analogy for a weed to turn into a human, but it means it's really like, it's not a good analogy, because it should be the farmer in just a different form where they know what they should be doing, but they don't do it at all. And then once you start doing it, everything's like awesome, because you're like, oh, I was looking at like what it could be if it was crappy, but if I actually just do it with an open mind and I do it wanting to see if there's something of benefit and cool that I can appreciate, I've yet to find a single thing really, for the most part, that I would engage with in my normal flow of life that I can't find joy in. Like, even a difficult situation with a difficult person, like, if you approach it with the understanding that, oh, I've been there, and that sucks where they're at right now, and they're not going to hear that, so all I can do is kind of be a little bit of a punching bag for a moment, because I can, because they're not actually going to punch me, and if I take their wounds, and I don't let them take their punches logically, and I don't punch back, and I also, like, I let it wound me a little bit, but not enough to make me angry, just to remind me how this person's hurting. And you do that long enough, and that person's anger just assuages, because they're taking it out on another person, and that's not the person their anger's targeted at. And then the whole soup of projections slowly dissolves, as the person realizes that they don't want to be the way they're being. And potentially, by projecting the anger in such a directed way, they may realize who the anger is actually directed at in their past, which can connect them to whatever thing was that was actually of conflict between them and that person, and maybe they can resolve it. Again, everything's really intention-based and belief-based, so if you build a structure for resolving these things and they actually resolve, then that's reality. Like, I've been talking to some people that are younger, kind of in that lost place where I was, you know, where I was just trying to optimize my ego identity and make myself awesome in this world, and then, you know, stumbling with, like, little things where, you know, my behavior within this identity construct wouldn't align with these deeper id desires, and would just break the ideology because ultimately it came in conflict with my actual self and it didn't make any sense. Anyways, in order to be able to embody this kind of communication between both sides, first you have to have a construct to perceive it that way, so that your mind can build from that model. And then you have to be able to let go of the desire to be in control of everything, to the point that you actually, like, really do release your ego's will, to the point where yourself can explain why that's just one aspect of you that got programmed, and you're a much bigger possibility. You know, part of the reason I think that the stagnation of aging happens. Hitting this point where I'm 42 right now, and I should be hitting a new stage of desiccation, deprecation, I don't know, both. And instead achieving this new unified plasticity where my body feels like it's growing an understanding of itself, much like when it was a child or a teenager, and feeling youthful and healthy in ways I haven't in a long time. Well, I'm gonna keep going with my story as long as it wants to go. Right now, every day is a gift, so as long as I can stay healthy and keep a clean mind, I can't really imagine a thing that would take me down, because like I'm not even upset about how everything is. Like, I am, but not in the way where I get angry and I want to take it out on anyone, more like where I feel motivated and like a call to action to stop perpetuating the damage of the past on me onto the future. If everybody does that, then slowly we don't project our damage onto our children, which I really feel like just due to the nature of our situation, my ex-wife's probably giving them very traditional and healthy whatever, because she's super loving. And also, I feel like it's a little bit of a competition. She knows that she has to be a particular quality of person for her children to not think she's a lesser parent, probably. And which is good, sure. We should compete to be the best people we can be in our children's eyes, and not just mime it, but actually embody it. I think that's all I got for now. I guess just exploring the muscle memory of the body in the mirrored way is awesome. It so far for the past several months builds daily based upon the experiences of the prior day. Keeps life fresh and keeps building new possibility in my mind, experiencing things that I haven't experienced for decades and creating new experiences through the adult perception of those. It's just when you don't lock yourself down to a particular ideology that makes you a servant to your own mind and instead a partner, reality is amazing. Anything you've ever seen in another person, crazy or sane, is possible within yourself. It's just whether or not we allow ourselves. When you take the constraints off belief, yeah, it can be dangerous. But if you go to it with an ideology of non-harm and benefit, I feel like it all leads to the same open, accepting appreciation. Like, we can't ever know an answer that's specific because language, it lacks the fidelity needed to maintain the meta of everything. So we just have to enjoy it, and all this stuff that we think is possible of it, we just have to acknowledge that maybe there's a guiding network of consciousness that we experience, and has a communal goal of joy and this target of heaven on earth, where everyone essentially believes the same open thing and just enjoys and appreciates everyone's company. Amen.